Good afternoon, everybody. This is Jeff J. Brown, China Rising Radio, Sinoland, and Normandy, France, on the D-Day beaches of Normandy. As you can see behind me, this is not Shenzhen. This is my wife's family's old vacation home on the coast in a little town called Arromanche, A-R-R-O-M-A-N-C-H-E-S. Which I'll be writing about later because of the D-Day story. This old house is from the 19th century, and her family's been coming here every summer for over three generations. So here we go. This is a really, really interesting show today. If you want to truly understand how the Chinese think and act, govern in the face of difficult odds. The title is Confucius, Lao Tzu, and Buddha are humbly winning against the Imperial West in troubled Hong Kong. Pictured above, left to right, is the depiction of the famous allegorical story of Confucius, Lao Tzu, and Buddha, each tasting vinegar in a vat, the interpretation of their results. Today's Hong Kong could be represented by the vinegar. All three are in mind and spirit, watching over China's wayward territory. Here we go. There is a great allegorical story about Confucius, Lao Tzu, who was the founder of Taoism. You may have heard it with a T also, Taoism, but it really is Taoism, and Buddha gathering around a vat of vinegar to taste it. Confucius and Lao Tzu actually met and spent time together in the 6th to the 5th century BC, before Christ. Buddhism did not make it to China until the 1st century AD. Other than the latter's conception of reincarnation, three philosophies have much in common, and all are looming large over the problems happening in Hong Kong recently. In the story, Confucius thought the vinegar tasted sour, symbolizing that people needed a system of values and an understanding about how society and government needed to be guided. Buddha tasted bitterness, representing the toils and troubles during our existence on earth. That being greed, vainglory, and anger. And the only way to overcome them is to clear our minds and souls of all selfishness in order to attain inner peace and enlightenment. And then there was Lao Tzu, the original hippie, uber Mr. Natural, who thought the vinegar tasted just grand because that is the way it is supposed to taste. So why fight it or criticize its essential being? Just take a step back and life flow, baby. Groovy, dude. Since there are many common threads in all three philosophies, over the centuries they have melded into a popular Chinese belief system under the rubric of, quote, Buddhism, end of quote. All three are very much part and parcel of what transpires in thousands of temples across China when citizens go there to pray, meditate, and make offerings. These commonalities center around humility, forbearance, relenting and retreating in the face of insults, violence, and arrogance. I have written about this way of life and how it has helped me enjoy a fuller, more meaningful existence. It can generally be encapsulated under the Chinese concept of zhen, which means to relent in the face of aggression or arrogance. And we are seeing this way of life unfolding before our eyes during all the protests and violence happening recently in Hong Kong. Before we get to ancient Chinese philosophy not kicking butt there, you first have to understand that the West, via their spy agencies such as the CIA, MI6, DGSE, BND, etc., and cover NGOs among the 37,000 present there, which are also funded by the likes of the National Endowment for Democracy, the NED, pseudo-liberal billionaires like George Soros and Pierre Omidyar are organizing and paying for all this ongoing mayhem. I wrote about this during the last imperial attack on Hong Kong called the Umbrella Revolution. Like then, the West is paying thousands of unemployed people 20 to 30 euros a day to hit the streets and create havoc. Sensing weakness on the part of the Chinese due to their adopting ancient Chinese Zhen, there are reports that the CIA cabal is now paying top dollar to try to destroy Hong Kong's way of life, up to 5,000 Hong Kong dollars a day, that's about 650 US, for those willing to wantonly destroy property and attack the police. Sometimes they get caught in the act. Below is a photo of an obvious Western spook directing Hong Kong protesters. This clown's t-shirt says, quote, "Freedom is freedom, pussy," end of quote, or, quote, "Freedom, freedom, hello," end of quote, depending on whether you use Cantonese slang. And for social media in China, the big yellow characters paraphrase, quote, "Be on the lookout for these evil devils," end of quote. I've been informed by locals that his name is Brian Kern, and he is a well-known CIA / color revolution operative in Hong Kong, all in a day's imperial chaos and mayhem. Photos like the one below were also taken during the Western paid-for Maidan color revolution in Ukraine, 2014. Chinese social media text above says that these people were being paid Hong Kong $1,000 to march for a day, Hong Kong $2,000 for chanting against the government, and Hong Kong $5,000 for tearing the place up. All this kind of blatant evidence is widely circulated across Chinese social media, so everybody except Westerners know exactly what is going on. Baba Beijing is publicly calling for investigations into, quote, "foreign meddling," end of quote, of the very violent Hong Kong protests turned riots. Again, it's not rocket science except for clueless, brainwashed Euranglolanders. Given the obvious, I was at first frustrated that Hong Kong authorities, clearly with China's nod, retreated from passing the extradition law that would allow Taiwan, Hong Kong, Macau, and the mainland to send wanted crooks to the origins of their crimes. Even after living and working with Chinese people for 16 years and fully understanding and adopting their practice of Zhen, as a Westerner, it's normal to genuflect, screaming an eye for an eye, a tooth for a tooth, so shove that law down those foreign manipulated punks' throats. That's how we think and react, and at first, I was thinking Hong Kong's leaders were looking like muddle-headed fools. Confucius, Lao Tzu, and Buddha were all on all the leaders' minds. Incredibly, at least from a Western point of view, Hong Kong's governor, Mrs. Carrie Lam, on behalf of her administration, profusely apologized to the whole world for not doing a good job, for not communicating well the extradition bill's intent, for underestimating the people's concerns and failing their expectations. For days, they showed the utmost humility and contrition to their citizens. Imagine that happening in the West. Not. Then Lam kept a profile for a few days to let the dust settle. Yet ancient Chinese philosophy is proving to be victorious in the face of relentless Western attempts to destroy Hong Kong's and, by extension, mainland China's way of life. You could call it Muhammad Ali's rope-a-dope strategy, or give them enough rope to hang themselves. And that is exactly what has happened. The CIA gang perceived all of the aforementioned Zhen as a sign of weakness, turned up the violence dial by ordering their goons to sack the Legislative Council. They estimate it will take millions to fix and up to 6 months to reopen its doors. This is the result of Western propaganda's, quote, "peaceful, freedom and democracy loving protesters," end of quote. Below is a montage of short videos to show just how much damage these Western thugs did to the Fedco. As a result, there is now widespread anger and revulsion by the vast majority of Hong Kong citizens against the protesters. And Baba Beijing is using it very effectively to remind China's 1.4 billion citizens what real Western freedom and democracy offer: violence and chaos. The whole fiasco has blown up in the West's imperial face, and all it can do now is double down on the mayhem, because that is all it knows what to do. Colonial capitalists have the brains of reptiles, run around like Komodo lizards, killing everything in sight, only thinking about ever more money, property, possessions, and power at the expense of everyone else and the survival of planet Earth. We now have young Hong Kongers supposedly inspired by these animals to commit suicide, quote, for the cause, end of quote. The West puppet local leaders saying they would rather die than allow the extradition bill to pass. In the face of a civilization that above all cherishes social harmony and economic stability, the West is committing long-term hari-kari while again handing Beijing a massive anti-Western democracy, public relations coup, both on the mainland and in Hong Kong. We'll get to the point where most Hong Kongers will be counting the days when the territory is completely reunited with the mainland on July 1st, the year 2047, while green with envy, gazing at 40-year-old Shenzhen next door, I've lived for the last 3 years, which is already a generation ahead of Hong Kong, all thanks to Confucius, Lao Tzu, and Buddha showing the way. Governor Lam has since come out offering to talk to the protesters, refusing to drop the extradition bill, which will eventually pass, mark my word, as well as demanding that all the imperial traitors be identified, arrested, and prosecuted. The Hong Kong Moral Majority also organized a big demonstration in support of the beleaguered police force, which has shown incredible zhen, and for the government. In the end, global capitalism will have won a Pyrrhic propaganda battle, but has already long lost its sabotage war to destroy the Chinese's communist socialist way of life. So, to Confucius, Lao Tzu, and Buddha, hear, hear, 3 cheers. In closing, here is a funny acerbic tweet, probably from a Brit living and working in Hong Kong. Not all Westerners are brainwashed fools. This is Jeff J. Brown signing out, China Rising Radio Sinoland, in Arromanches-les-Bains on the north coast of France in Normandy. Have a wonderful day.